There's something mystical and mischievous about fungi.
I tend to move my hands a lot when I talk. I hope that's okay.
I've been working this for 20 years and my son won't eat white button mushrooms. Mushrooms are actually very unique. They're not a plant, they're not an animal, they're in their own biological kingdom.
And what's more interesting is that marriage between the mystical, magical fungi and sustainability.
It's an interesting concept. Mushrooms is what you eat and what you see, and that's the fruiting body. And mycelium is the root part that you typically don't see, but that's what we're interested in.
Growing mushrooms is not easy. We've been doing it for almost 100 years now. Internationally, we're known as one of the leaders in this field. From an environmental and sustainable perspective, there's been a lot of interest recently on using mycelium in ways we never thought of using it, in building materials, structural materials, architectural materials.
I've never worked with living materials, living things in design before. So why don't we go and, you know, talk with the Mushroom Research Center director to see if we can work together.
When Vinay approached me, you know, their group are the experts, you know, they have the expertise in working with integrity, structure, and things like that. My expertise is in biology.
We need to solve the 40% of global carbon emissions that the building industry contributes. We need a paradigm shift about how we design and how we build. Working with a living material requires a completely a new mindset because it wants to be something or it doesn't want. Like, you cannot just make everything with a living material because you're working in collaboration with that organism.
I just think there's so much potential of mycelium as a material that we've just begun to scratch the surface. The other thing that really fascinates me is this idea that you could grow high-quality protein. So where mycelium comes in is when you look at the cross-section of fungal mycelium under the microscope, you see these really wonderful fibers that resemble highways. When you look at a piece of meat fiber, like under the microscope, you see these really interconnected highways as well.
Yeah, I think the drive for sustainability has definitely been what's been pushing the micromaterials, and I don't see that slowing down. Pennsylvania grows almost two-thirds of the U.S. mushrooms. One of the original faculty members developed something called grain spawn that was patented here at Penn State and really changed the way the industry grew mushrooms. A large aspect of what we've done for the growers, besides just the research, is the education and the outreach of what we're finding and helping training the growers. And then honestly, another component is providing them educated students coming out of Penn State that can fill some of the voids that they have needs of in the industry.
Penn State is a really good place to do fungal research or mycology. It stems from our history with a land-grant institution with our College of Agricultural Sciences.
Penn State has a facility dedicated for doing cultivated mushroom research, and it's the only one in the U.S. And without it, we wouldn't be able to do the work that we do. You have to kind of know both the art of growing to do the science accurately.
What really inspires me are people. I could sketch out a crazy idea and walk down to my colleague on the third floor and ask, hey Greg, do you think this is a really crazy idea? And he's like, oh, tell me more. Why don't you think about this? Why don't you consider this? So I never felt that it was a competition. I always felt it was very collegial and it was a community trying to lift each other up. That really encompasses the Penn State experience for me.
John was very accommodating. Even when we made a huge mess, he was okay with it. And I didn't encounter any kind of, you know, closed doors. That's something I really like about Penn State because, you know, me as an architect, I have limited knowledge about the biology and the mycology and material science aspect. So it really requires a network of collaboration like the fungi does in nature. Did it work?
Nice. Yeah, that's great. Yeah.
Okay.